Hello, welcome to Snails and Fairy Dust. Today I'm going to show you how to make these beaded feather fringe earrings. This is the specific earring we're going to make today, which sort of starts small, gets bigger, and then decreases at the bottom. But I just wanted you to see these other styles of earrings so that once you've mastered this technique, you can take it to so many different places by varying your colors and the amount of beads. So in this particular one, you could see I've used the same amount of beads for all of the fringe all the way down, and you end up with this sort of shape. With this one, I have increased the fringe and then decreased and increased the fringe again, which gives you this sort of shape. And in this final one, I have just decreased the fringe all the way to the bottom, which gives you this long sort of triangular shape. So you see, like, the sky's the limit. You could come up with so many different cool styles and shapes and variations. So let's take a look at our supplies and get started. Today, I'm using a size 11 Miyuki seed bead, not Delicas. These are the round seed beads. I have these cute little French ear wires with balls at the end. I also have a size 12 beading needle I'm using today. It's a slightly bent, but we're not going to worry about that. I use my needles until they die. And then the most important thing today is I'm using a lighter weight of thread. I'm using a 2-pound weight of fire line rather than 6-pound. You could also use a nylon beading thread. The most important thing is you don't want to use a thick thread like a 6-pound weight, because we pass through the beads so many times that it's going to become tricky if you have too thick of a thread. And then I always have scissors, and that's all we need. So let's get started. Okay, so I am starting with about 4.5 to 5 feet of my beading thread, and I like to run it through my nails, especially with the fire line, to get it nice and flat before I thread my needle. It just makes that process a lot easier. So I'm threading that, and I'm going to pick up 4 beads. It's going to be 1 pink, 1 gold, 1 pink, and then 1 gold. Like that. Slide it down towards the end of my thread. I want to leave a, like, 3 to 4 inch tail. And now I'm going to bring my needle around and back up through all 4 of those beads. There you go. And now I'm going to bring it, my needle back up through just the first 2 beads. It's almost like ladder stitch right here. So bring it back up to these first 2 beads. Should have that little square there. And then I want to secure this so this loop isn't able to slide back and forth. So I'm just going to take my needle and I'm going to slide it underneath the thread. Pull that almost all the way through until you just have this little loop. Bring your needle back through that loop and pull it. And now that is not going to go anywhere. And you can continue to add the rest of your beads. So we're going to be adding 3 beads at a time and sort of looping them around. So in the pattern is pink, gold, pink, like that. And then I'm going to bring my needle through the other side of the center gold bead. And that is going to form a little loop. And I want to get back to the top of that loop. So I'm going to come up through this side one on the pink side, or the one on the side, which is pink. And then I'm going to come through the top gold bead, like that. And we're just going to keep doing this. So we're going to pick up our next 3 beads, pink, gold, pink. We're going to stick with that pattern. And then we're going to come through the other side of this top gold bead. And then we want to get to the top again. So we're going to come up through the pink bead. I need to just flip this over so that my hand doesn't block you. Come up through the pink bead. And then through the gold bead. And we are at the top again. Let's take a look at that one more time. We're going to pick up 3 beads. Eventually here. Okay, 3 beads, a pink, a gold, and a pink. And we come through the other side of that gold bead that was at the top. And then we want to get to the top again. So we're coming through the pink bead on the outside. And then through the gold bead at the top. Now for this pattern, we're going to have 16 loops of these. So you should have 16 of these center gold beads or whatever color your center bead is, but 16 of them. And when you get to the point where you have 16 of these loops, come back here, and then we're going to do something a little bit different for the 17th loop. So you keep working through that. Make sure you're keeping enough tension in these loops. You don't want them to be all loosey-goosey. That's why you hold it in between your fingers when you're pulling tight, just to keep it really tight there. And if you need to go back, you see any gaps, don't worry about going back and taking your time. But this is the foundation for your whole earring. So you want these to be nice and tight. Okay, I'll see you back here in a second. Okay, so here I am. I'm about to add my 16th loop. And once I do that, I'm going to do something a little bit different for the top loop. So I'm just finishing that up. Here we go. Come back through that top bead. And then next, I'm going to add 4 of the gold beads. And these 4 beads are going to end up becoming the loop that I attach my ear wire to. So basically now we're at the top of the earring. We started at the bottom and now we're at the top. So I'm going to bring that loop through, and it's 4 this time rather than 3. And then I'm just going to come around that loop again. So back up through the second 2, down through the first 2. And then I'm going to go through that top center gold bead right there. So I'm going to go through that. And then I'm going to go through the closest outside pink bead. So I'm coming down through that, because remember, this is actually the top of the earring. And then I'm going to add 1 pink, 1 red, and 1 gold. Now the gold beads here are going to become our end beads. So I'm going to slide all of those down. And then I'm going to bring my needle through the red and the pink bead, skipping the gold because the gold one is going to hold it in place. So I go through the red and the pink bead, and then that also that original pink bead that is on our center loop. So when I pull it together, I have this little tiny fringe. And then I'm going to come through that center bead again. This is the bead that's going to get passed through a lot. And then I'm going to come through the other outside, the exact opposite pink bead. Like that. And then I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to add the same exact fringe on that side. So 1 pink, 1 red, 1 gold. There you go, 3 beads. I slide those down, and then I'm going to skip the gold, come back up through the red, the pink, and the original pink that's on that center loop. There we go. And now we need to cross over again. So we're going back through that center bead one more time. I'm just turning this over so I don't have to put my hand over the work. So I'm going to go back through the center bead. And then I'm going to come down that outside pink bead again, from the original loop, like so. And then I'm going to cross over to that center, through that center gold bead. So I'm going to cross through that, and I'm going to make my way to the second loop coming down. So through this outside pink bead is where we're going to start our next row of fringe. All of the fringe is working off of that original center column. So now for this one, I'm going to add one pink, two red, and one gold. So we're increasing. So one pink, two red, one gold. Skip the gold, come back up through all those beads and through the original pink center column bead. And then I cross over through the center gold column bead. And then get to the pink on the other side of that center column. And I'm going to add the same exact beads. So one pink, two red this time. And one gold. There we go. Slide that one down. Again, we're going to skip the gold, come up through the two red, the pink we've added, and the original pink on the center column. Take your time and just understand where your beads are. This is going to feel a little tricky in the beginning, but once you get it, this is all we're doing for the whole earring. So it's, you just have to learn this little technique, finding the right beads to go through, and you've got this. So now we're going to cross back through that center column gold bead again. And then through the outside pink bead of the center column. And we're going to work our way down to the next loop. So once we come out of there, we're going to cross through the next silver or gold bead in the center column. Like that. And then we want to make our way to the outside pink bead of that center column, and we're ready to add another row of fringe. I hope you're starting to get the hang of it by now, but let's just look at this one more time. This time I'm adding one pink, three red, and then one gold. Like so. And we're going to do the same thing. So skipping the gold, come up through the three red, the one pink I've added, and the original pink. Sorry, I hit the camera there. And then we're going to cross through the center column gold bead. And then come through the outside pink column bead there. And now add the exact same fringe. One pink, three red, one gold. And so you see now we're increasing on each row of fringe. When we get to where we have five red beads, you're going to come back here and then I will show you the pattern sheet so we can sort of know where we're going for the rest of this earring. But we're doing the same thing again, crossing through the center gold column bead and then down through the outside pink column bead. And then in the opposite direction, we're coming through the center gold bead back across. There we go. And then we add our next row of fringe. And for this one, it's going to be four red, one pink, four red, one gold. Okay, we come back up through there, make that fringe, cross over to the other side, do the same exact fringe. I hope you are feeling more confident now. Because once you get this technique down, like this is really a fast earring to make. And as I said in the beginning, there are just so many fun variations you could make with this style of earring. So here I am at... I've increased to five now. So I went from four and then after four is five. And I just want to show you this. So it's 16 rows and for seven of the rows, we're just going to stay at five. So that's row five through 11 are all going to have five of the second bead. I'm calling it B on this little chart. It's the red bead. But whatever colors you're using, whatever second color, you're going to have seven rows of five of those beads. So we're not increasing, we're not decreasing for those seven rows. So I'm just going to speed through that here. And then after we get through the 7 rows, then obviously we decrease again. And if you need to keep that little chart with you, just take a screenshot, pause it on that part of the video, go back there, pause it, take a screenshot, and or write it down so you could have something to follow along with mentally. I know sometimes it's just nice to have things written down so you don't have to think. Less thinking is always great. So here we are. I think I'm almost done with my sets of 5. There, I think that is the last one. And now, yep, now we have 4. And we're going to decrease till we get to the end there. And this is just like we've been doing. And then when we get to the very bottom, then there's just a slightly different technique for that very last little bead. So keep going. We're almost there. Now I am on my second to last one. And these are short little rows of fringe, just 1 pink, 1 red, 1 gold. And it sort of mimics the shape of a feather. So, you know, we started out smaller, we got bigger, we got smaller. And then we just have left over now that tippy bottom center bead, which we're just going to add 1 bead to. So I'm going to come up just like I was doing any other row of fringe, come through the center bead, down through the outside bead, and then through the center bead again. But this time I don't have the outside pink beads because this is my very center. And so I'm just going to add 1 gold bead. And then I'm going to loop around and come back through this center bead. So I have 1 gold bead, and there's that 1 bead on the bottom, which doesn't have anything coming out of it. And I'm going to loop back through that bead. Try not to get everything tangled up here because we still have that original tail. So try to keep that out of your way. So I'm going to pull that. It's a little tricky to see here. A better view in a second. And there it sort of sits at the end to even out that bottom row of fringe. So then I'm going to come back through the new bead I've just added. And then loop back into that original bottom bead. Going back in there. And now we have finished all of our fringe. And all we have left to do is to weave the threads in. And I'm going to show you how I do that. So basically, weaving the threads in, I'm going to work back through that center column. And that's why we want to make sure we have a thin thread, because this is a lot of passes through that center bead. It's probably had maybe 4 or 5 passes by the time you're finished. So I'm just going to work up through that center column and really weaving around the circles, which is going to give me a lot of tension in my thread and secure it and make sure nothing's going to come out. So I'm going through those pink beads of the center column and then back through the gold beads of the center column. And what I'll do is work up a few rows until I can work down one of the fringe. So let's just watch that for a second. Okay, so now on this one, instead of continuing to work up, I'm just going to work my way down this fringe. I'm going to get about halfway down it. And then I want to make a little loop so I can make a knot. So I loop that around, make sure I hide my knot in between the beads, like so, and then come down to the end of that fringe, work my way back up the fringe, and then I'm good to clip this thread. Everything should be plenty secure in there. And then I'm just going to do the same thing with that original tail thread. Just weave that back in. You don't have to make a knot with that one because we already had a knot, but weave that back in and clip it. And then we add our ear wires. So just loop that through. With this sort of ear wire, you could just press it with your fingers. You don't need a pair of pliers to open and close it. And there we go. We have made these pretty little feather earrings. These are actually my favorite color combination, so I'm very excited about the specific pair for myself. And then if you want to just take a look at these other styles again, I hope you're super inspired to come up with all sorts of different styles and variations. You can make them longer or more sparkly for occasions like Christmas and even bridesmaids, like boho bridesmaids earrings or wedding earrings. You could add pearls and whites and like all sorts of fun things. So I hope you were inspired. I can't wait to hear about what you've created. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe and stick around for more fun beading videos. Okay, thanks guys. Bye.